Hello everyone, I'm Nick Murphy and today I'm going to be bringing you another cast between Millennium Stefano and SKMC. This is game 3 of their best of 5 played at the Red Bull Line on the previous weekend. So far the score is 1 for MC and 1 for Stefano, so it's still anybody's game. Last game MC did a ridiculously strong 2 base all-in with 7 gates, massive amounts of zealots. And Stefano got a very, very unfortunate supply block and just couldn't pump out the units necessary to defend it. It was ridiculous. Like, he got a very, really unfortunate supply block. Anyways, so up here in the top left of Antigua Shipyard, that is Millennium Stefano spawning as the Red Zerg player. Down here in the bottom right hand corner of Antigua Shipyard, SKMC spawning as the Luprotoss. MC going for yet again the Forge Fast Expand. There's really no reason not to Forge Fast Expand on almost any map. It's pretty much a given, like you can automatically do this. And MC is scouting cross spawn first, because I think on this tournament version of the map you're forced to spawn cross, because if you spawn here, for example, the third is like right next to the other person's main. It's kind of awkward. So MC doing the little probe harass again. Let's see how this goes. And Stefano is building up 200 minerals, going to get the pool at 15, as he has done for the past every game so far. MC just going down there, seeing if a hatch first went down instead. Which it didn't, but there's always a possibility. This map is actually well known for being like a really good map to cannon rush on, because of, like, you could stick a cannon here and deny a bunch of mining here, and stick a simulator on here and get vision of the high ground really easily for just 75 minerals. It's well worth it, I think, for the Protoss player. Sometimes. It's not all the time. Like, it depends how you do it. And if the Zerg reacts, like, really well, you're really far behind doing those cannons. And MC going for the Forge first for the 19th time in a row. And then going for the Nexus at 17. 17 Nexus. Or now it's 16 Nexus or something. 18 Nexus. I don't know. So, yeah, that's what I meant, 18. He's going to be doing a wall. I guess he's going to put a gateway there and a cyber there and then stick a zealot in the hole. Or maybe he'll put 2 gateways. Who knows? If he sees a Lynx coming, I'm sure he will put 2 gateways. Or put an extra gateway there. Actually, no, that makes no sense, because he'd have to also block it. So he'd be screwed if Lynx come. Once again, Lynx escorting the drone over to the third, so he can take a quick third. Without the risk of any sort of cannon rush or like cannon denying the third or whatever. It's really important to send a Lynx. Maybe like if I were Stefano, I'd probably be patrolling around or have an overlord there, which he has none of these two things, because a probe could sneak in here and it looks like he is sending a probe there, but it's okay, he found it with his Lynx, so that will not be a problem. MC throwing down a very quick cyber core, and only one gas again. Looks like we're going to have a repeat of last game. Let's see if Stefano can hold it off this time, or if MC will take another quick victory, leading him in the series 2-1. Yeah. Queen's getting up there. This queen will probably walk over here eventually, or maybe not. Not this game. He's just going to make it at his third. Oh no, he's walking. Oh, or not. I don't know. We'll see. Stefano keeps making me look like an idiot the whole game. I don't know, we'll see. And he's getting a quick creep tumor, because he can't really afford to use all the larvas anyway. Yeah, I'm not even sure why he did the first inject. He probably could have gotten away with doing a tumor on the first time instead of an inject, because he has no money. He can't really spend all these larvas anyway, so it's okay. He's going to be plugging a zealot in this hole, or not. Where's the zealot? Okay. Zealots go and do some early poking. Force out a little bit of early links. And let's see when MC decides to add the redonkulous amount of gateways, which he did last time. He's going to go put some proxy pylon with this probe here. Oh, trying to deny Overlord scouting a bit. Hopefully he does not lose this Overlord, because it's very crucial. That's pretty much what lost him the game last time, is losing an Overlord and getting supply block. Let's see what Stefano sees. Has he scouted very much? No. He knows there's no double gas here. Like, he knows there's, at the very most, there's 2 gases, so he's expecting some sort of all-in. But he can't really assume that it's the same all-in, even though it is. Another 7 gates here. Jesus Christ. And he's gonna warp in the five star. Like, it's gonna be a complete repeat of the last one, except the crucial difference here is Stefano has, well, not earlier roaches, but he is gonna have earlier roaches because he's not getting supply blocked this time. Last time he got majorly supply blocked, which ruined his entire thing and killed his boner, pretty much. And yeah, that pylon will be going down, or will be going up, I guess, is what I should say. And Stefano getting it one spine right here, because it could cover the ramp and this ramp. That's why he puts it there. And MC going to put a pylon on the top here will most definitely get denied. There you go. And there's the big warp in of Zealots and Stalkers, but I think, yeah, he. The main. Oh wow, the spore crawling. That was not even a spine, that's kind of weird. The main difference here is that he started churning out roaches quite a bit earlier because he didn't have to get supply blocked or whatever, so he's. Oh, that's actually really close. He's still turning out roaches, and MC can only afford Zealots, so I don't know, it's gonna be close. If he can micro well. Yeah, I think that spore crawler was kind of weird. If he didn't have the spore crawler, I think it would have been a lot better. If that was a spine crawler, that would have made a huge difference. But look, 9 more roaches. That's going to be able to clean that up. 9 more roaches, 16 speedlings. Lots of roaches coming down here. Reinforcements from the back. Everywhere just going down. Ooh, it's actually going to be really extremely close. MC's all in. Like it's the same build as last time, so if he holds his third, he pretty much wins automatically. And it looks like he's going to do that. It looks like he's got just enough units. He's going to keep the producing the units and get the Zealots over here into a tight choke where only like one or two can attack at once. And looks like Stefano will thwart the attack. Actually, no more four Zealots here. And oh, geez. No, he's got this. He's good. Stefano has thwarted this all in. And he pretty much wins now because he already held the third. And MC kind of foolishly warping in. I mean, it's already all in. Now it's even more all in. It's just ridiculous. Like, he shouldn't be warping these in my opinion. He's just wasting more money. He could be warping in at home and starting to tech up, starting to do stuff instead of spending all more money in this attack, which is already dead. So yeah, and Stefano going to lair. This attack was, yeah, definitely completely thwarted. Really well played by Stefano. The big difference there is he did not get supply, but what the? And he's still warping in. This is a really big mistake by MC, I think. I think he's just desperately trying to break through, but it's not gonna happen. It's honestly just, there's absolutely no chance. And now that pretty much cost MC the game. MC is way behind. He's adding three gases all at once just to try to desperately catch up. He's adding the cannons because he could counter and win pretty much, so we're gonna have to see how this goes. Yeah, he's running out of money too because he went all in. He had like no probes. He's just chrono out the probes just to desperately try to catch up. But all hope is pretty much lost. I mean, Stefano has this for sure. That's a lot of roaches. And he could pretty much just attack right now, actually, and win with this. And the drone, random drone here. Let's see. Okay, he has more gateways than he can afford because of the all-in. And he's trying to get saturated. He's about saturated on two bases. But he won't be able to take a third because Stefano's there taking it for him. And this is actually not as BM as it looks because, I mean, he could get faster reinforcements, I guess, technically. And Stefano making a big contain here, which could potentially backfire if he doesn't do it right. Now there's two hatches on the way, another macro hatch, an additional macro hatch, and this expansion here, quote unquote expansion. Yeah, this could backfire if MC just like stays on two bases for a long ass time and then just turtles up and gets like 200 200 force. I mean, roaches can't really kill that alone. He is gonna add hydras now, but yeah, so he could, like, if he adds like colossus or something. Yeah, he is adding colossus. I don't know. He's just gonna get a gigantic bank. Stefano is, I mean. Like, he'll be able to remax, like, infinitely more times than the MC. He's a whole entire base ahead. Plus, he has this extra production. I guess, and he has six spread, too. Like, really good concave gonna happen. He's preemptively adding the Spire because he's gonna add a bit of everything. He's gonna go, like, Roach Hydra Corruptor, which will outright win the game if he's that far ahead. I mean, look at the supply counts. 173 to 101. That's ridiculously in Stefano's favor. MC probably should have left a while ago. No offense, though. He's sticking in there, giving it all he can. And here's some drones to saturate this. And like I said, the Hydras will get here quite a bit faster. Whoa, what's happening? Nothing. If he builds Hydras here, since they're really slow off creep, they'll get here a bit faster, so at least there's that. Now he's taking the formerly known as the gold base, but now is actually just a normal base because of the tournament map. Because if Terran gets the gold, they're pretty, like, yeah, I mean, Terran can get the gold pretty easily, so that's why they took the gold out, because it's kind of hard to balance with the gold in. Almost all maps have the gold taken out in tournament versions. Hydra range upgrade and range attacks level 2 coming out. This game is pretty stagnant. It's pretty clear that Stefano's going to win this. He can remax, look at his money. He's almost maxed and his money's like piling up, and he'll be able to remax in just like a millisecond. It's not even going to be close. And he's getting this just in case, DTs or something. Like, he that's what you do when you're ahead. You prepare for literally anything and you're still way ahead. And he's going to start attacking this these gateways a bit. Random stalkers going. Changeling drop, but MC picks it off right there. Yeah, MC is looking pretty far behind. Stefano's getting his fourth up. He has like a well-saturated fourth and even like two drones at his fifth. And he took out two gateways too. Not that he could afford that many gateways with the Robo and Colossus. He is getting out second Colossus now. If he continued turtling until at like 100% max and got like really good upgrades, which he can't do. He has no money. It's just retarded. Like, he can't really do anything. He's actually killing some of his own units now to make room for supply for some corruptors, which he's making over here, I guess. Oh, random overlord making over there. So yeah, he's getting the corruptors in because he does need that to take out the Colossus. But it really doesn't matter at this point, and this creep is going to take forever to come back for MC to go and expand there. And if he doesn't expand there, he's running out of money, he's running out of minerals in his main, he's even running out of minerals in his nat, and this is pretty much like an extended version of an all-in by MC here. So if he doesn't win with this attack, he loses, and Stefano can remax like a retarded amount. And Stefano with the flank, and the Zealots over there getting teared up by this. Now, MC will probably be able to take this army out, but he is not going to be able to take out the follow-up army. That's just not going to happen whatsoever. Look, 32 Roaches in production. He just cannot compete with the production of Stefano right now. That's just because he sacrificed so much economy to do that early attack with all the Zealots that... And Stefano held his third, so he was, like, ridiculously far behind. 54 Lings on the way as well. Behind that, I mean, there's really no way he can do anything. He has one Force Field or a Guardian Shield. And there's it, and MC should be leaving right at this moment. All the 54 Lings swarming in, and Stefano takes game 3, leaving the match 2-1 in favor of Stefano. Well, I hope you enjoyed this cast. This has been another high-level cast, Game 3 of Stefano versus MC. If you have any questions about the game, about any Zerg strategy, or about StarCraft 2 in general, feel free to leave them in the comments. They will be answered in the next video. If you want free coaching, email me at nickyboy909@hotmail.com. If you want one of your own replays casted, email them to me as well, and I'll look into casting them. If you have any questions about the replay or whatever, like what you could have done better, I'll try to help you out as much as I can. So yeah, this has been another high level cast. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Please give me some feedback, but not too much feedback. It really drains my energy. I apologize for that joke. Anyways, I'm Nick Murphy. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye-bye.